economist argues amendments to the Philippine Constitution are not necessary to bolster foreign direct investments. That's as House lawmakers revive charter change efforts. During the House deliberations, former NEDA Chief Professor Solita Winnie Monsod said studies have suggested foreign investors see no problem with the Constitution's imposed restrictions on foreign ownership. She believes some lawmakers are using the issue as smokescreen for their agenda.
The overall FDI restrictiveness index is statistically insignificant. It means it doesn't make a difference. I hate to say this, but you're using FDI restrictiveness. I think the Congress is using that, you know, as an opening door to get all its political. The evidence shows that you don't have to remove it, because it doesn't matter.
Meanwhile, a political science expert says the timing of proposals to amend the Constitution is questionable. He asserts there are more dire issues that should be given priority.
Sa dami ng problema ng bansa natin, na sinabi niyo na nga, no? Parang kada buwan merong agricultural product or food product na nagiging problema, no? Yung timing, no? Tsaka sa tingin ko, kailangan wag sana maging tone deaf yung ating mga mambabatas, no? At pakiramdaman kung ano yung dapat na i-prioritize sa pagbangon natin bilang bansa.
Philippine Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa stressing the need to strictly regulate Philippine offshore gaming operations, or POGOs. De la Rosa suggests containing them in one location so they can be monitored better. Senators earlier this week grilled the Philippine gaming regulator over its supposed insufficient response to illegal activities of POGO firms. Despite the reported crimes, De la Rosa insists he is not against POGOs.
Hindi naman lahat ng Pogo companies ay involved sa krimen. Mangilan-ilan lang ito, mga rogue elements ng Pogo industry na na-involve sa krimen. So to be fair naman, hindi naman sila lahat masasamang tao, and meron din naman sila nag-contribute sa ating ekonomiya, kahit na sabihin mong ilang billions lang yan, pero considerable amount pa rin yan, nakakatulong sa atin sa ating mga pangangailangan.
The Philippine government gets more financial assistance from the Asian Development Bank. The ADB just approved a $500 million loan to help the government revitalize the COVID-hit labor market. It's also aimed at supporting programs that address skills mismatch and promote training to retool workers. The ADB sees the policy-based loan as a tool in creating an enabling environment for existing and emerging businesses to spur more employment. Another legal setback for San Miguel Energy Corporation, its petition for a temporary restraining order that's supposed to stop the Energy Regulatory Commission's denial of its motion for price adjustment has been denied by the Court of Appeals. According to the ERC, the court decided against SMEC's petition because it failed to prove its right to a restraining order. It adds the CA's decision will help ensure low costs of energy supply from San Miguel. The case stemmed from ERC's denial of San Miguel and Meralco's motion for price adjustment upward in their contract. The U.S. President Joe Biden's stern warning on the future of the world's largest economy. Biden lashed out at the Republicans, saying their economic proposals would only be catastrophic and chaotic for Americans. The president insists economic gains under his administration should be protected, including the creation of more manufacturing jobs and better-than-expected economic growth figures. The U.S. economy grew 2.9%. in the final quarter of 2022, bringing the full-year GDP growth to 2.1%. Biden vows to veto Republican proposals.
What in God's name would the Americans give up the progress we've made for the chaos they're suggesting? I don't get it. That's why the MAGA Republicans deliberately choose to inflict this kind of pain on the American people. Why? Why? This nation has gone through too much. We've come too far to let that happen. I will not let it happen. Not on my watch. I will veto everything they send me.
MAGA, of course, is made in reference to former President Donald Trump's Make America Great Again campaign slogan back in 2016. Biden also rejecting Republicans' refusal to approve an increase in the U.S. debt ceiling unless they get a deal on spending cuts.